Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Dark Souls 1. My name is Renekin, and, well, I'm sounding like a hooting idiot, to be honest. And we have managed to not die on the way down here to the fucking bone wheels. And I was thinking, is it bad that I do, skip so much by going down to Vamos? And I'm thinking, well, no, because that doesn't take away the mystery, what could be on the other path. And I probably will go down there at some point, maybe, just to show off a bit. But what we are going to do is probably... we don't have that nice thing equipped. We will do a little suicide run to get an ember from a blacksmith corpse. But first, we will get here. And those are very tricky. You have to be very, very careful, because those assholes are going to kick you down. And if they kick you down, yeah, you're probably insta-dead. Insta-dead. Insta-daddy. And he's dead. And hello, you're dead too. Insta-dead. So another large soul? I heard we're doing soul popping at the end of the episode and leveling. Only heard that. Don't know if it's true. And we're here. And I don't know where the fuck I am. I never was here. I've played through this game more than 10 times now, and I never was here. Or is it I never were here? Was it was or were? No, I never was here, right? It was I was, you were, he, she, it, was, we were. Like, the I and the... Please don't die. Thank you. The I and the he, she, it is always the exclusion, right? And the rest was always were. Right? I don't know. Grammar with grandma. So, down there is like a death trap. Look at those fuckers run. And back there is my ember. But, if we do it right, we can sprint, equip the homeward boat, jump down here, get the ember, roll! Whoa! Run! Get the soul! Run further! Yes! Please! Yes! Oh, that was fluent like fuck, man. I am really happy about that. That went good. That went really, really good. So, now we're going up here. And we can meet Patches. Patches is an Easter egg character. And... in every Souls game, there's a Patches version who is going to trick you. You can't untrick him. He is always going to trick you. In every game, even Bloodborne, even in Demon's Souls, there's always Patches.
Good day. You look reasonably sane. What are you doing in the catacombs? Are you a cleric or something?
So if you say yes, he's pissed at you because you're a cleric. He hates clerics. But if you say no...
No? Really? Then I'd have no qualms telling you. There's a fine stash of treasure right down that hole. I found it first, but, well, we're friends now. I'll split it with you. In any case, have a look. It'll shimmer you blind.
So, he's a giant asshole because the following will happen. Ouch!
This is what I do, my friend. The trinkets I'll be stripping off your corpse, that's
the real... Fuck you, Patches! I will get you next time! Fucking Patches! So, down here, we have a few souls and a skull lantern. The skull lantern... they do that on purpose, of course. It's game design why they do this. The skull lantern... So, you run down here. If you equip the skull lantern, it makes usually light. But, see, you see that back there. But since we have the maggot already, we don't need the skull lantern, really, because the skull lantern illuminates everything only. But, well, not only that, but if you do that, you see the way to Nito. That's really cool. You can see the entire way to Nito. But since I know the entire way in and outwards like my fucking own body. My body is ready. We can just go here. And here's Rhea of Thorland, which we met earlier with her two faggoty boys.
You're no hollow, are you? Thank goodness. Please be careful. There are two fierce hollows not far from here. They were once brave knights, my former escorts.
I'm no hollow.
Let such strong spirits be hollowed so.
I don't know.
They're nothing. Nothing at all to be done. You're no hollow.
Yeah. Same dialogue. So, her both companions hollowed because they were down here, lost all hope, right? Hollowing, all hope lost. So, they have both very high poise. Very, very high poise. But they have, like, mediocre health. So, they were easy kills.
You banished those two hollows, did you? It pains me to think of the trouble my failings have caused. I am certain that both Vince and Nico are grateful to you.
No problem, bitch.
Thank you so very much. Here. These belonged to them. You deserve them more than I. I am certain that... Thank you.
Yeah, she's only thanking us. Now she will move to the... if you remember, back at the beginning, at the Undead Burg, in the church, she will move now to the altar where the dead firekeeper was. So that's the thing. And if you put that, take that titanite chunk, that white titanite chunk, those will spawn. And those are meanies, because the meanies, they will fall over, they will do this attack, and other than that, they don't do much. They can bury themselves and pop up somewhere else. They're like diglets. Diglets. And, yeah, that's this area, basically. It's nothing special. Like, nothing special, really. But what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Skeleton boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they boner you? That pun! So, I have a joke. No, I haven't a joke. I joined a joke contest 2 days ago, and they said, well, you can win money if your joke gets taken, and I've submitted 10 jokes. Well, wait a second.
Oh, you. I. Well, let's just calm down. Talk about things.
Yeah.
I did you wrong.
I'm filling my coffee up.
I didn't mean it. These temptations.
By the way, still same day because that muck.
You know what I mean, don't you? Please, forgive me. You and me, we're jolly undead outcasts, aren't we?
Jolly undead outcasts, aren't we? So I can forgive him or kill him. If I forgive him, he sells me equipment. If I kill him, I don't get anything. So I forgive him. I'm nice to Patches. He has a bald head. Also, he and Lautrec hate each other.
Brilliant. A second chance. Wonderful. I had a feeling you'd understand. I did. But if I were in your shoes, who knows what I'd have done. But now we're friends again. Eh?
I trust Patches. He's an asshole. He's a psychopath, but I like him.
I did you wrong. But I didn't. Please.
Yeah. Blah blah blah. Lord Shrek, by the way, hates Patches. If he stays long enough there, in the filing shrine, and you don't kill too many bosses, he would say, I don't know if he did it on our playthrough, if I know trusty Patches, and that he hates his guts, and that if he sees him, he was going to kill him. Yeah. That's the thing. And Lautrec, by the way, is, yeah, by the way, there's a Black Knight coming here. Sorry, forgot to tell that. Lautrec, by the way, also tells you, if he lives long enough, that this will not happen to us now, but I will tell you, so, that... Whoa. Petrus and Rhea have a common past, and that Petrus is very envious of her and wanted to kill her. So, Petrus is not that innocent as he does. And Lautrec is, by the way, very cool. He's quite an asshole, but he is very helpful if you to unveil some things, like how they ended here. And yeah, Lautrec says, like, yeah, no, that Petrus guy is a total douchebag. And if you have him live, and Rhea is back at the shrine, and Petrus is there, Petrus will say, well, haha, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to kill Rhea. And now we get into some depth, because if you kill Petrus, you sin. That makes you a bigger target for online invasions. If you don't kill Petrus, Rhea gets murdered. He murders her. And Rhea gives you, miracles for cheaper. She gives you more miracles, I think. So Petrus is a giant asshole. So I always kill him, by the way. I always kill him. Rhea has done nothing wrong. But yeah, we will explore that more in the Rhea storyline when we get to that. So this is the last bonfire before Nito. Oh yeah, I'm hollowed. I have to pop a humanity. Because we will do an NPC invader who has a very cool set. And we have to kill him here. Because, by the way, NPC invaders only can occur like online invaders when you are a human. But NPC invaders can only spawn when you have not the area boss killed. While online invaders can come every time they want. They come in and say, hello, I'm online invader douchebag. How are you doing today? Mr. Rene, how are you doing today? Oh, fuck you, souls. My god. Why don't I just do this? Hello, how are you doing today? You feeling dizzy? You feeling invady? No.
Well, then I invade you, motherfucker.
We will charge down here. There's, by the way, many, many little secrets. You can jump off some of these ledges and get to some places. It's very interesting, but again, we're under a time limit, and I don't want to take everything away from you. I want to make this enjoyable, and we will explore more again when we do the things pre-Gwyn, where we do the quest lines and explore a bit more. So, next thing here. This is another later area down there. We will get down here, and this is the bottom of the world down there. It's not going any deeper. And maybe I will probably put a little artwork up that some very good artist did in the Swords community, of the entire world, which is very cool. And this guy is Paladin Leeeeroy. He's a direct thing for Leeroy Jenkins. He's a paladin. He's called Leeroy, as you can see. And yeah, He's like a reference to him. And he gives us the Grant and the Sanctus. The Sanctus heals you over time. It's a very good shield. And the Grant is a very good, or a good hammer. Not very good, but it's okay. And if you kill Nito now, his paladin set will be back at Nito. And the paladin armor is the best medium weight armor in the game if fully upgraded, I think. I used it on my New Game Plus 7 character, so I have quick rolls and very good armor, and it never let me down. So we skip those assholes. We will do the Nito fight, by the way, one time at least. And here are the pinwheels I talked about. They are here, normal enemies. But also, zombie babies! And they are following you everywhere. And what you want to do is you want to get up here one time. Whoop! Hello! Ouch! No! No! And you want to get in here. Dodge that one, bitch. And get this one, the Titanite Slab. Yeah, well, you don't want to. You can, because divine damage is only good in this area, really. Because divine damage allows you to kill the undead, all of them. You do bonus damage, I think, to them, and they die for good if you kill them with divine damage instead of the normal damage. So divine damage is very, very nice for this area, but we're at the end of it. Like, there's not much to come here. This is the final boss of this area, not of the game. But yeah, we're gonna jump down to Nito. I'm just getting a bit of stuff ready, because by the way, he does an attack that is a jump scare. Not really a jump scare, but he does like a woman scream, and then a scythe jumps out of you, under you. He does that most of the time as an opener. And there's Nito. He's like in his coffin. Cute little boy. I'm talking like that is too much information. I'm trying to do commentary here, but I cannot follow up and can't stay in the picture. I'm really, really sorry. Hello, Nito. Good day to you. You have a scythe, and you are built of undead. So, Nito is the very first undead person ever. Which is quite interesting, because as the first undead person ever, he's kind of a douche. Because I will kick his ass now. I should not say that, because usually when I say I'm gonna kick someone's ass, I'm probably going to die. But Nito is quite slow. And here's the jump scare attack. It's way scarier the first time you do him solo, because you are not... Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh, I hate that. I hate that attack so badly. Yeah, and that happens usually when you enter the arena. Whoa, I can't lose sight of Nito. He's very dangerous with his attacks, because they are slow, but they do tons of damage. And run away again. But you see, he's not that hard, actually. He's one of the easier ones. Well, I think, and to be honest, I think most of the bosses are, after a certain time, easy. And he's dead. So we killed the very first undead. We killed two of Gwyn's main people here already. We are doing very good progress. And now the undead here in this room will not spawn anymore. And we are going to grab that paladin set, which is over... Paladin set? Hello? Paladin set! Where's my paladin set? I want to have my paladin set. Hello. That's not normal. Wait a second. I want to get my paladin set. Quit out. You will see now a few characters of mine. So, do not worry. This one is the Let's Play character. I'm sorry to show you my menu, but I want to get the paladin set before I finish this episode. Come on, where's my paladin set? There's my paladin set! Yeehaw! So I've got my paladin set now. Now I'm happy, and now I can end the episode! Goodbye! Ciao, ciao! Auf Wiedersehen!